folks, and welcome to Beckley, West Virginia. In the game, it's one of the more, shall we say, beat-up locations in the Appalachian wasteland. But in the real world, it's a charming and thriving city that has a rich and vibrant history for both West Virginia and the coal mining industry. It's a classic American town with a diverse culture and plenty to offer visitors and residents alike. And I, for one, am anxious to discover Beckley's treasures for myself. So come on and let's go. Ready to discover Beckley, Coyote? Well, let's do this. The area where the city of Beckley, the county seat of Raleigh County, West Virginia, sits today, was originally the home of a number of indigenous peoples and is recognized as the ancestral home of the Monoton tribe, a Catawba-speaking people who live primarily in the Kanawha Valley near the Kanawha and New Rivers. The Monoton people thrived in the area from approximately 1000 to 1750 Common Era. Though little is known of them, it is suspected they merged with the Siouan-speaking tribes habitating areas of what is today Northern Virginia. It's also possible the Tutelo, the Monoton's neighbors to the south, may have absorbed them into their own nation as well. These peoples were eventually absorbed into the much larger Seneca Cuyahoga Nation. Other communities that claimed the area were the Cherokee, Shawnee, and Yuchi peoples. Initial conflicts with the European settlers farther east resulted in the smaller tribes being displaced and settling deeper into West Virginia. Approximately 80 years later, in 1838, Beckley was founded and named in honor of John James Beckley, the first clerk of the U.S. House of Representatives and was also the very first librarian to the Congress. John Beckley's son, General Alfred Beckley, was responsible for founding the town. Initially, the town only really existed on paper, as at that time, about the only structure there was Alfred's home, hardly enough to qualify it as a town. Because of this, Alfred was said to have been regularly mocked for his paper town. But because of his successful mill operation and other enterprising efforts, the town began to grow. In its early years, the town was sometimes called Beckleyville and then as Beckley-Raleigh Courthouse, for a while the only structure in the fledgling town, which at the time was located in Fayette County, Virginia. But in 1850, Raleigh County was created under the Act of the Virginia Legislature and Beckley officially became the county seat. The town's initial growth was slow, and with the advent of the Civil War, the town's growth stagnated. During the war, Beckley was occupied by both Confederate and Union forces at various times. In 1863, the struggling town fell victim to the brutal violence of the war when it was shelled by Union forces. After the Reconstruction period, mining operations began in Raleigh County, which was rich in coal deposits. In 1890, the C&O Railroad constructed a line to service Beckley, and that line was completed in 1901, and a few years later began servicing the Great Winding Gulf Coal Field, a massive and coal-rich area adjacent to Beckley. In 1908, the Virginian Railway completed a line that ran to the ports of Virginia, and coal production nearly doubled because of it. In the span of just a few years, Beckley's population went from about 342 to a little over 2,000. The sudden spur in population led to the construction of new homes, schools, and churches. Businesses began popping up in 1906, and Beckley saw its first theater, the Carter Opera House, which opened with the production of The Merry Widow. Because Beckley's economy was heavily dependent on the coal mining industry, its stability fluctuated with it. Though the city fared better than most during the Great Depression of the 1930s, coal prices fell and led to the closure of a number of coal mines in the area. In the 1940s, World War II necessitated an increased demand for coal, and Beckley was instrumental in meeting that demand. But when the war ended, production decreased once again and economic hardships returned. In the 1950s, the construction of the West Virginia Turnpike, which ran from Charleston to Beckley and Princeton, delivered an eagerly anticipated economic boost. In the 1960s, Beckley grabbed the national spotlight when presidential candidates John F. Kennedy and Hubert Humphrey both visited the town, stopping at the same street corner. And recognizing one another, they engaged in a friendly chat while on the campaign trail. A decade later, the energy crisis of the 1970s created a new demand for coal, and production geared up once again, allowing Beckley to prosper once more, which was sustained well into the 1980s. However, the increase in mechanization led to the loss of thousands of Beckley mining jobs, which brought a new economic downturn. Fortunately, Beckley was able to sustain the impact of the industrial changes because of the fortunate location between two major interstate highways. This allowed for new business to locate here, allowing Beckley to diversify and not be solely dependent on the coal industry for economic survival. At the close of the 20th century, Beckley was one of West Virginia's fastest growing cities. Today, Beckley, sometimes known as the smokeless coal capital and the gateway to southern West Virginia, is home to the West Virginia Institute of Technology and two large healthcare facilities, including the Veterans Administration Regional Medical Center. Beckley is also home to three radio stations, a public television station, and the Register Herald, the daily local newspaper. The nearby Raleigh County Memorial Airport provides access to air travel for the town. Beckley hosts several museums, most notably the Beckley Exhibition Coal Mine, which is located in New River Park. Adjacent to the Coal Mine Museum is the Youth Museum of Southern West Virginia, which offers children and adults alike a fantastic and immersive experience of the rich history and culture of West Virginia. Tamarack, a fantastic arts center showcasing West Virginia's arts and crafts and celebrating the diverse talents of the state's artists, is located just off West Virginia Turnpike in the heart of Beckley. Opened in 1996, Tamarack has since generated over $100 million in revenue and has been visited by over 8 million visitors eager to see and purchase unique pieces of art selected by a panel of expert judges who choose what can be displayed and sold at Tamarack. Nearby parks to Beckley include Grandview Park, Lake Stevens, and the spectacular Twin Falls State Park. Winter Place, a local ski resort, offers exciting winter activities and lots of fun in the snow. In the summer months, Theater West Virginia runs two annual outdoor musicals in neighboring Grandview. And to get a glimpse of where it all started, you can visit Wildwood, the home of town founder General Alfred Beckley. The home has been restored to its original state and is one more great museum to visit when touring Beckley. So now that you know a thing or two about the town of Beckley, what do you say we tour it for ourselves and see just how close it matches to our Appalachia wasteland version? I'm sure you're going to recognize a thing or two, and just wait till we get to tour the actual coal mine. So pack your lunch pail and let's visit Beckley. One of the first attractions I came to when I started my walking tour of the town was this amazing cardinal sculpture that cheerfully greets visitors and welcomes them to downtown Beckley. The northern cardinal is the state bird of West Virginia, as well as that of Ohio, their neighbor to the northwest. Surprisingly, the sculpture does not have an in-game equivalent, but what does is this fountain just off the town square. As you can see, the fountain definitely has an in-game counterpart and is in the exact same location as it is in the real world. Another familiar feature that we see all around in both the in-game Beckley and the real world Beckley are the classic 1940s era fire escapes. Now this one is approximately across the street from Sal's Grinders in the game, but notice the real world counterpart. It looks a lot more like the back of Sal's Grinders, and I have to wonder if this site may have been the inspiration for it. Grinders. Boy, would that make for a great lunch. What do you say, Coyote? Ready for a quest? Well, let's find Sal's Grinders and have ourselves a classic West Virginia lunch. Walking down North Fayette Street, we see a number of buildings that certainly look familiar to us wasteland explorers. Now mind you, you're not able to travel from one to the next on makeshift suspension bridges to avoid a lot of angry robots or hungry feral ghouls, but you can certainly take a pleasant walk through the town and enjoy some classic American post-war architecture from the early 1950s that gives Beckley its wonderful hometown all-American feel. Thank you. No grinder shops over there, or over there either. Oh well, on the corner of Main and Haber Streets, you'll find some historical markers that commemorate the founding of the town as well as its coal mining heritage. In the game, the massive coal fields we know as the Ash Heap are located just outside of Beckley. In the real world, the much more massive Winding Gulf coal field is located just outside of the town limits. One of the most popular destinations for those visiting Beckley, both in the real world as well as in the game, is the Beckley Exhibition Coal Mine Museum. It's a fantastic historical village dedicated to West Virginia's coal mining heritage, and there's no better place to experience it than right here. The main building houses both the Coal Mine Museum and a wonderful gift shop, exactly as it is in the game, only much nicer and a lot safer. Entering the museum, you'll be greeted by friendly staff at the ticket booth where you can purchase your tickets for the underground mine tour and where your adventure begins. Come on, let's check it out! You'll notice the windows match the in-game version. Now, the in-game version are broken, but notice the panes are the same. Then, as you go around the museum, you'll see the displays. The cases are very similar, and what's inside is exactly what you see in the real museum. The underground mine tour runs about every hour, giving you plenty of time to take in the exhibits of the museum, which is an excellent way to learn all about the history of mining and what it was like to work in a mine in both the early days as well as more modern times. There's lots of authentic pieces of gear and technology used in coal mining and wonderful displays to give you a glimpse into the unique and often hazardous life of the amazing and dedicated men, women, and for a time even children who worked in the coal mines. Now, one particular exhibit that all of us wastelanders might recognize, most especially those of us who just love getting a hold of those mole miner pails full of goodies, is a display case full of various miners' pails. There's a wonderful variety of these unique pails, along with panels full of educational information detailing the significance of these pieces and the role they played in coal mining history. There might not be any power armor pieces, ammunition, or fancy lad snack cakes in these pails, but they're part of an amazing history you can see firsthand. Check this out. This display illustrates the various gear an early miner wore when working in the hazardous environment of an underground mine. Notice the breathing apparatus complete with the filters and so on. It's very reminiscent as to what we see the mole miners in the game wearing, and it's certainly likely the designers took inspiration from displays like this one when doing their research. There's a fantastic room full of tools and equipment used in the early days of mining, and it really helps to put the challenges the early miners faced into perspective. And just down from that is a wonderful exhibit illustrating a typical company store. Hey, speaking of company stores, let's check out the fantastic gift shop and see what it has to offer. Stepping into the gift shop, you'll be treated to all kinds of exhibition coal mine gifts and souvenirs perfect for every style and taste. If you want to commemorate your awesome visit to this amazing museum, this gift shop will have something just perfect for you. There's a wide variety of beautiful stones for the geologist in your family. There's all kinds of books on West Virginia, coal mining, and all sorts of other related topics. There's plenty of cookbooks, and speaking of good cooking, just check out that variety of homemade fudge. There's lots of t-shirts and apparel for children and adults, stuffed animals, hats, and really great Beckley Exhibition coal mine sweats. There's magnets, mugs, stickers, patches, and badges too. And you know I love badges. There's actual historical mine pieces you can take home and some absolutely amazing actual coal carvings and sculptures. Oh, and what's this? You can even get a lump of coal. I mean, I'm used to getting these at Christmas, but here, you can get them year-round. How cool is that? So be sure to visit the wonderful gift shop either before your underground mine tour or after you return. You're certain to find the perfect keepsake to cherish your visit here forever. And speaking of the mine tour, they just called our group. Time for the main event. Let's go. Now in the game, just outside of the museum, you can see the remnants of what used to be a coal mine tour. But sadly, it's not running in the wasteland. But not so in the real world, and boy oh boy am I happy about that. So follow me, and let's take a ride into a real coal mine. Once inside, you'll take a seat on a small train which will be your means of transportation into the depths of the underground mine. Prior to departing, your driver and tour guide will provide you with an overview of what you'll be seeing in the mine and go over all the important safety information you'll need to be aware of before entering the mine. Most of the tour guides were miners themselves, so they are not only experts on the subject matter, but they provide unique and personal insights that make the tour so much more meaningful and engaging. All around you in the departure area, there are displays of gear and equipment used in the mines, as well as video monitors playing videos about the mine. Then comes the big moment everybody's been waiting for. The train rolls into the mine and your adventure begins. Along the way, your guide makes several stops to show you various key sites in the mine and tell you all about the mining activities that took place there.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood.
This mine shut down in 1910, and the city of Beckley bought it. When they bought this mine, it was only this high. The first thing they did, they hired a company to come in and shoot the rock from the top of these cars up to what you see today. And so they could do mine tours in here. And this makes 61 years of doing tours in this mine.
The deeper you traveled into the mine, the more fascinating the tour becomes, as you'll learn all about the trials and tribulations of early coal mining and see exhibits of more modern activities as well.
They would take this light and they'd hold it up to the top. And you watch that flame. Well, if that flame doesn't do anything, there's no methane here. If you had methane gas, here's what this flame would do. It would start growing and growing and growing and growing. Now, if it goes up to that bottom line, you got 1% methane. If it goes up to that middle line, you got 2%. If it goes up to the top line, you got 3%. Now, if you got over 5%, it will actually explode inside this light without blowing up the whole mine. As soon as they drill them 5 holes with the shot fire, he would put 3 sticks of dynamite in each hole. Now we went from shooting 3 little balls of black powder to shooting 15 sticks of dynamite. That's a big blast. So if you hear somebody holler, fire, fire, fire in the hole, you better find you a safe place to get real quick.
Mr. Vine, the other of steel, if the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Once outside, the train will take you past several of the historic buildings on site, including the Slab Fork Coal Mining Company Superintendent's Home, before returning to the depot where you started. When you arrive back at the depot, you can enjoy a meet and greet with your tour guide, who will be happy to answer any questions you might have and share some amazing stories of real coal miners. It's a perfect prelude to the next phase of the tour, which is a walking tour into the coal mining camp. Here you can see how coal miners lived and what their lives were like in the early days of coal mining. As you visit the various camp buildings, you get to see firsthand firsthand how the miners lived and get a true and very personal insight into what their home lives were like.
I'm going down to Charleston, through the shadow of the mountains this road winds, to close up towns, forgotten dreams and welcome signs fading far behind. Cold country. I'm thankful for the sun to die. Didn't bat down from a federal fight. Where the lead lies still and the smoke still rises on the Blair Mountainside.
You can see a beautiful little church where the miners and their families would gather to worship and spend time together outside of the confines of the mine. And then, on the other side of the Youth Museum, you'll discover what early life in West Virginia was all about by visiting an early frontier town. The buildings are perfect replicas of mid-19th century mountain homes, and they give you a fantastic and accurate look at what early West Virginia pioneer life was like. There's a blacksmith barn and several homesteads that you can visit. Wow, I guess tiny houses go back farther than we thought. Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed my visit to Beckley, and I certainly hope that you'll want to come and visit it for yourselves. There's so much to see and do here, and it's truly a wonderful place to get to know West Virginia's rich culture and really experience the impact the coal mining industry had on the state and why it's such an important part of their heritage.
That's who the government stamps and codings for. We may have won a few battles, but we lost the war. Now we're slaves to poor. Poor country. It put a roof over my head. In the arms. Appalachian stone.